Goats grow on trees now? Well, not all goats. But across the Argan orchards of Morocco, goats have learned that to get the good stuff, you have to get a little high. These are Argan fruit munching, side road attraction show stealing, tree climbing goats.
I'm Danielle Dufault, and I'm in an Argan grove, and you're watching Animalogic.
We're in Morocco, searching for one of the internet's most iconic animals, the tree-climbing goat. This is a beautiful land, full of amazing wildlife and breathtaking landscapes. But the funniest creatures of them all are the gravity-defying goats. We heard that they could be found on the side of the road in the western part of the country. We saw plenty of regular, land-loving goats, but it wasn't until we got closer to the city of Essaouira that we looked up and saw a billy goat blocking out the sun. When you see these dudes, the first question that comes to mind is always, what in God's red earth are you doing up there? But let's start from the beginning.
Picture this. It's an extremely sunny day and you've been driving down the highway for what feels like hours. Past nothing but arid shrubland. Decide to take a break in the shade under an Argan tree. And then all of a sudden, a wet nugget falls on your head. You look up, and there's a goat glaring back at you. Don't worry, he's just dropping a few Argan fruit on your head.
Oh my god, these guys climb way higher than I ever would have expected. Holy cow! I mean, holy goat? Holy goat.
Goats are built for climbing, from steep rocky mountain faces to man-made dams, and of course, Argan trees. There's almost no place these weird-eyed guys won't go to find snacks or escape predators. Their hooves are evolution's answer to the rock climbing shoe. The hard outer edges grip the tiniest ledges, while the soft inner pad helps them stay stable, even on slippery surfaces. Think of it like wearing hiking boots with built-in shock absorbers.
This is so impressive. This goat here is like 20 feet up in the air. Come on, you have to agree with me that these are the greatest of all time when it comes to climbing. Right now, I'm standing in the middle of an Argan grove. And you might have heard of this plant before from fancy shampoos and moisturizers, but here in Morocco, it's also a source of food. The fruit are sweet and nutty, and a goat superfood.
In fact, Argan fruits pack more energy per bite than most of what goats scavenge from Morocco's arid landscape. And honestly, if you were a goat, would you rather chew on dry, thorny bushes? Or even having to fight bees for access to water? Or snack on delicious tree candy. These goats love the Argan fruit because they're delicious and nutritious, but they also love the leaves. And of course, I use their love for everything related to the Argan tree to get a little closer to them. Got a little overexcited, but what are you gonna do? You can't really argue with goats.
No. You silly gooses! I mean, silly goatses.
Silly billies.
Silly billies! You silly billies, what are you doing? I can't even be mad, really. Like, you can have it, it's fine. But it might not be good for you. You silly gooses.
These goats are especially used to these fruit because they are domestic goats. Farmers brought them over for their meat and milk, but also because of their ability to survive in harsh conditions. The goats, on the other hand, found out that the farmers' food was more delicious than their own and decided to figure out how to get it themselves. This could easily become a source of conflict, but the goats make up for their appetite for fatty fruits by producing milk, which is then turned into the most delicious cheese I've ever eaten. and also by bringing unexpected guests to the farmers, Argan tourists.
There's a whole industry based on the Argan groves, and the goats are one of the main attractions.
From the goats' point of view, this is the dream. They get to gorge on delicious, nutritious food, and the farmers let them, because tourists will pay to see the world-famous tree goats. The farmers make a little money from the show and sell their products. But of course, anything this cute and Instagrammable comes with a catch. Tourism has turned these goats into local celebrities, leading some farmers to place them in trees purely for the photo op. In some areas, goats are manually put onto artificial platforms with no way to get down, forced to stand in the sun for hours and endure constant human attention. The stress can take a serious toll on their well-being. Those goats standing in one spot are unfortunately unhappy goats. If you want to make sure they're happy goats, go to a place where they're free to jump from tree to tree and eat whatever they please. If they're not eating, there's no reason for them to be up there. Ironically, the less picture-perfect goats might actually be living a more natural life. A broken horn can sometimes be a sign of a full, adventurous life. Goats aren't exactly the smartest animals, and accidents can happen when they're busy dining in a tree. Thankfully, in good farms, there's usually a shepherd to help them along.
A lot of these goats have broken horns, and as we just saw a few minutes ago, sometimes they do take tumbles down from the top of the trees. But they also seem pretty darn hardy and haven't really sustained any kind of injury beyond breaking a horn here and there. Fortunately, horns do grow back for their entire lives. Not all tourism is bad. There are great Argan co-ops where farmers get to grow and sell their products for great prices. And as you can see, there are goats that climb trees for real. It's just a matter of finding the right place.
Some tours will take you to less ethical spots where goats are kept on tree platforms just for photos. So do a little research before you visit these beautiful weirdos. But while you're here, take the time to learn about this incredible tree, one that supports the livelihoods of tens of thousands of people.
But enough about the goat, let's talk about the MVP, the Argan tree. These ancient and gnarly trees are more than just playgrounds for the goats. They're the keystone species for their entire ecosystem.
Argan trees are found almost exclusively in southwestern Morocco, where they have adapted to survive the region's harsh, dry conditions. Their deep roots anchor them in sandy or rocky soil, allowing them to tap into underground water sources while also preventing erosion and desertification. The tree's waxy leaves help reduce water loss under the punishing sun, and its small yellow-green flowers provide nectar for honeybees, which produce a uniquely nutty-tasting honey. And for humans, the tree's fruit yields argan oil, highly prized for both high-end cosmetics and traditional cooking.
Getting oil from these little fruit is very labor-intensive, and that's why it's so expensive.
After harvesting the fruit, it needs to be dried for several weeks. Then, the pulp is removed, leaving only the nut behind. These nuts are among the toughest in the plant world, and must be cracked open by hand to extract the kernels. The kernels are then ground into a thick paste, which is kneaded to release the oils. The oil is then filtered to remove any impurities. To produce just 100 milliliters of oil, you need over 30 kilograms of argan fruit. So yeah, it makes sense that it's expensive. The goats help the farmers in yet another way, besides giving milk and looking cute on the side of the road. When they munch on the argan fruit, they eat the pulp and swallow the tough nut whole. After it makes its way through their digestive system, it gets pooped out, and the seeds get spread around, helping the trees grow.
Because of their deep root systems and their wide branches, argan trees require a lot of space between them. And it just so happens that these goats are the best seed dispersers they have.
These seeds can also be harvested for oil production. The goats already took care of removing the pulp and drying them out, so oil from these nuts is often a bit cheaper. But hey, it's really up to you if you want oil from argan nuts that have been through a goat first.
Unfortunately, if you want to do this, you're going to have to act fast, because argan trees are facing serious threats from climate change.
Rising temperatures and prolonged droughts are putting immense pressure on these trees. Since they already grow in some of the harshest conditions on Earth, they're at risk of extinction, which would also mean the end of the tree-climbing goats. More importantly, it would devastate the communities that rely on these trees for their livelihoods. But it's not all doom and gloom. Local and international efforts are underway to protect and restore the argan groves. Sustainable farming, educational programs, and ecotourism all play a role in ensuring these trees, and the goats that climb them, stick around for generations to come.
So what do you want to talk about next? Please let me know in the comments and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Thanks for watching. See ya! Gotta tickle your noses.